Okay, I had chemo yesterday, right? The video you're about to see was shot yesterday evening in one take. All right, I just let the camera go and I just kept going. A little bit of editing, but you know, it was just I was pretty wired, you know, per usual, and I was getting ready to mow, and I decided to shoot a video instead. And I'm wearing something you've never seen before, or something I'm not proud of, but I'll explain. It's Thursday, about 3:30 a.m. I have day after chemo. I've got four meetings today at work, mostly fun ones. I really want to check in with my team, and then I've got another meeting that has to do with my servers and doing some upgrades or something. So anyway. So yeah, I got to get going. I've got 5.5 hours to get ready for those. The first one's at 9. So anyway, yeah, it's this video is a little bit weird. All right. Thank you. Let's go. Oh, and when I got done shooting what you're about to see last night, I was both like wired and exhausted. So of course, I slept in the camper last night. It got down to like 48 degrees. I didn't even start the furnace. I just crawled in, and you know how the sheets are kind of cold at first, but then it warmed up. I slept all night with just a sheet on and just a comforter on part of my legs. I slept like a rock. Got up at, you know, 3:15 or whatever, so if you have trouble sleeping, get a camper, right? Okay, let's go. You're right. This is not my best look, right? You guys know, I hope you know, the goal of the channel is just to be very honest and raw with you guys because I replied to one of your comments and I said, yeah, you can spot a fake YouTuber like a mile away, right? This is not, you know, this is just raw. And I have been before. But so, yeah, I was on the deck just relaxing. It's a beautiful night in Minnesota, right? You want some lutefisk? Some lefse? But no, seriously, I was on the deck like processing. You guys know me, right? And by the way, today was cycle four of chemo. All right. I actually had a great time. That sounds really weird. But just a really quick shout out, and then I'll talk about what I was thinking on the deck. It's kind of really serious. You know, so right now, like, no Ava, right?
Wait, what?
Well, yeah, no, this is gonna be serious, all right? So just, you know, take a chill pill, all right?
Wow, okay.
Okay. So, a shout out to the staff at St. John's. All right. Barb. That's a joke. We were talking and I'm like, "So, do you prefer Barbara or Barb?" She's like, whoa, you know, thank you. Yes, it's Barbara, you know. And I said, you know, I thought so. I was just joking. I'm like, hey, Barb, you know. So, by the way, Barbara, you are really, really funny. You made my day go way quicker. You know, we were doing, you guys, the Mad Pack, right? My viewers, Barbara is a gem. We were doing like one-liners like all day. We were going back and forth and bantering, and you know, it was just thank you, Barbara. You know, right? And so, yeah, and Jennifer, this was like six videos ago. I didn't make fun of her, but Jen, my nurse, and Jennifer, I mentioned her in a previous video. Jennifer, if you're watching, I did not make fun of you. I loved your laugh. All right. And you did it again today. Jennifer, you are just the sweetest. I really appreciate you. And yes, today, you know, it was, we said something funny and it's like, right? No, I'm kidding. And the staff, we were laughing about Jennifer's laugh, right? So, Israel, I don't know if I spelled that right, but it was really good talking to you today, my dude. So, okay, really quick, Israel, thank you. But so Israel, you know, fairly young guy, I'm old, right? My zip code needs its own zip, my forehead needs its own zip code. I screwed that up. I'm going to leave it though. Not a blooper, but Israel, younger guy, right? But four kids, wife. And so he's taken, you know, I'm straight, right? So I'm not saying that. But so Israel, Israel had long dreadlocks at one point. You know, he showed me on his phone. And it's like, that's cool. My son Brian was thinking about it. But, you know, with our genetics, you know, good luck with that. So, but anyway, so Israel cut off his dreadlocks. And I'm like, what? I love dreadlocks. They're really cool. But tell me. See, I want to jam it with you. But tell me. You know, I can't do it. But so he cut him off, and and the staff were kind of making fun of his new haircut. Dude, it's like, now you belong on the cover of like GQ or something, all right? So you know, I'm just saying, like, you know. And by the way, Israel and I are polar opposites. He's really chill and laid back, you know, and I'm not, right? Especially on dexamethasone, as you'll soon see. All right. yeah. So anyway, you guys, yes, chemo was today. What happens with chemo? Steroids, right? Like I get wound up, you know, dexamethasone. So, yeah. So I'm like wired, but I was thinking, and the staff at St. John's, you guys are, you know, and the Mad Pack, you guys know, and I don't have to say it, it goes without saying, but please remember to always thank your staff, like, you know, because they probably, maybe, I don't know, maybe don't get enough of that, right? So tell the staff that they are awesome. Barb, you're awesome, and I told you that, right? So thank you to the staff at St. John's. Now, I'm rambling, I know. I'm just going to keep going. A couple of things. Number one, I was out on the deck processing, right? And I thought of something. Over the past, since last weekend, incomplete sentence, try to get used to it. Over the past 4 or 5 days, I'm shooting video, because I felt like I kind of needed to. As an international YouTuber, you know, we're kind of under pressure to like crank out the content, but then I'm thinking, and I'm trying to do editing, and it's like, it doesn't make sense, and it's non-contiguous. It's an amalgamation of a conglomeration. It's like, you know. So I'm struggling putting this stuff together because I don't know. I think it wasn't really coming from the heart. And you guys know what I'm talking about. And I'm going to piece together I'm probably going to cut this video off and just, you know, leave it at this with the other thing I was thinking. But so what's going to happen is, I hope, over the weekend, I'm going to try to make sense of what I was saying, Like, I go off on these tangents, and I'm doing it right now.
Calm down. Calm down.
So, yeah, this is not my best look. All right? You know, if I had a choice, you know, would I display my bat wings? Like, yeah, no. And I talked about that like 10 videos ago. Something I was thinking about, you guys, I am very, you know, to be honest, I'm kind of really concerned about my loss of muscle mass. All right. I used to like, you know, I used to have like, you know, I could go like which way to the beach, you know, is it over there or is it over there? I don't know, you know, but which is normal. I'm 62. All right. It's normal. Testosterone goes down. And so that's why I'm stirring, you know, oh, wait. All right, bzz, try to keep up. All right, so, and, you know, with a little bit of ADD, right? And my cousin Chris. In a previous video, I said, you know, I've got mild ADD, and she left a comment. Mild? Thank you, Chris. Appreciate that. But anyway, so yeah, I mix my protein powder in my coffee like every day, like it's like 500 grams of protein in there, and so I put it in there and I stir that, you know. And so you guys, I'm buzzing.
Calm down,
right? So I just want to do something funny. All right, so I have to kind of get set up for this. All right, now this is from the heart, this is not like forced. All right. Jeez. All right, so wait. Sorry, but did that work? I don't know if it worked. Dexamethasone, you guys. Now, one of my, what's it called? Like the small things in life, life's small pleasures, not a blooper. One of my small life pleasures is this stuff. I love this stuff. The coconut smell. And I told you guys in a previous video, I like slather this stuff on. And yes, we'll talk about the tattoos later, but anyway, so I'm out in the yard with this stuff on, but then you guys, I know. Before I get a bunch of comments, I get it. I should be using like SPF 1000 or something, you know, go to Home Depot and buy a quart of like white, you know, enamel and just put that on. It's permanent. But you know, I get it. All right. I get it. But I like the stuff. Okay. So, you know, right. I've already had carcinoma removed from the side of my nose, and I should have signed up for like the, you know, extra warranty, like another $500. They can like make my nose like smaller. Right. But so, yeah, I've already gone through carcinoma once. Being honest, I was on the deck just maybe half an hour ago, looking at my muscle mass, you know, lack of, but then I'm looking at my bat wing arms, and I am seeing, and I did tons of research when I had my carcinoma. I'm seeing spots like all over the place that fit the description of skin cancer. Brown, irregular, changing shape. They're all over the place. I was like a redheaded ginger, right? I mean, not so much anymore. You know, my zip code takes over. But what happens? You guys know I'm going through chemo for pancreatic cancer. Now, what happens if I talk to my oncology doc and I'm like, dude, I'm seeing things that are like concerning And there's like a lot of them. And Kathy, one of my best friends, you know, she's gone through it. And she's like, it's not that big a deal. And I know, I get it. This was not that big a deal. But what happens when they pull me in there and they want to do like a full body scan? And they gave me that term before with this, right? What happens if they find 20, 30, 100 of possibly malignant skin cancer tumors? Then what happens? Do they, you know, bring me into the OR and they do surgery on every single little one of these? And how do we fit that into my chemo? You guys know I try to be very raw and honest. You know, obviously, I mean, who does this, right? So anyway, yeah. Leave a comment, you know, and thank you. I could go on and on, ad nauseum, you guys know. Your comments, the Mad Pack, and my new Mad Pack family. And one of you asked, is it Among Family Next Door? And, you know, yes, it's a wonderful, loving, giving Among Family Next Door. So I've got a new Mad Pack next door. Anyway, you guys have left just a bunch of really funny, really funny comments that I really want to get to. And what I really love, you guys, is when you make fun of me. Like, you know, couldn't you have like cut those sleeves off like a little straighter? Because you guys know I'm like the most self-deprecating person that you probably have ever seen, right? So thanks for your comments. A bunch of funny ones that I really want to get to. And I will this weekend. Okay, I promise. I just have a boatload of comments over the weekend. And a ton of content. I bought a new mower. I did not read the instructions. I could not get it started. And then Karen, my neighbor, came over. And she's reading the instructions. She didn't say this, but it's kind of like, you idiot. No, that's not the, you know, you can hook up a hose and like blow out the deck, right? And there was two tubes sticking down. This is getting long, but a funny story. I want to leave you with something funny. So I thought those two tubes, and I took photos of it, the blade was hitting those tubes. And then Karen came over and read the instructions. She's like, you idiot. No, that's part of the handle. You have to like loosen them and raise them up. And then I used my gas pump, right? It fired up on the first start. So men, it's okay to be emotional. And number two, read the instructions. All right, I got to go, you guys. Sorry, Ava.
It's okay. I was listening.
Okay, that's good. All right, let's... I'll see you in the next video that's like not under pressure, right? Okay, so thanks, you guys. Bye. redo. And by the way, I'm going to be pumping out. I'm going to be pumping. Oh, jeez.